Welcome to the ThinkCell tutorials. This video provides step-by-step instructions on how to visualize your project timeline in a Gantt chart with ThinkCell. Go to the ThinkCell group in the PowerPoint ribbon, open the Elements menu, and click on Gantt Timeline. Use your mouse to position the orange insertion frame on the slide, and click once to insert the chart. Adjust the size if needed by dragging one of the handles. A newly inserted Gantt chart consists of activity rows, an activity column on the left to label the rows, the scales at the top showing the chart's date range, and finally a milestone row at the bottom. The default chart also displays an example activity bar and a milestone. By default, the date range of a newly inserted Gantt chart starts with the first day of the current month and includes the two subsequent months. To change the visible date range of your Gantt, just double-click on any of the scales at the top. This opens a calendar in which the current date range is highlighted. To set a new date range, click on a start date, hold down Shift, and click on an end date. Your new date range is now set and is automatically adopted by the Gantt chart on the slide. You can also drag the handles of the highlighted range to adjust the start and the end date of your timeline. When you are done, just click on the slide to close the calendar and return to editing your chart. ThinkCell automatically displays appropriate scales and separators for your individual Gantt. In this case, months and calendar weeks. There are also scales and separators available for years, quarters, and days. If you would like to display different scales and separators than those automatically picked, left-click into the top right corner of the chart and tick or untick your preferred option from the floating toolbar. Now that we have set the time range of the chart, let's start editing the activity column. It labels the different activities of the project. Click into the label placeholder and type in your text for each row. The width of the column will automatically adapt to the text you enter. To control the width of the activity column, hit Enter to word wrap your label text. To add more rows, right-click into the activity column of a row and select Insert Row. The new row is inserted directly below the one you clicked on. To delete a row, right-click into the activity column of a row and choose the red Delete button. If you would like, you can change the column heading as well. Just click on it and type in your new heading. Now let's move on to the timeline items. This is an activity bar. It visualizes the duration of a task. Click onto the example bar in your first activity row to select it. You can see a handle on each end of the bar. Click and drag the left handle towards the start date of your activity. A tooltip will show you the exact date of the current position, and release. Do the same with the right handle to set the end date. Now you have successfully placed your first timeline item. You can also double-click the bar, or indeed any timeline item, to open the calendar for that item and edit its time range from there. If a timeline item exceeds the visible range of the chart, an arrow is displayed to mark that it extends further. You can also see a dashed bar here. This indicates tentative activities. You edit it the same way you would an activity bar. To display a bar as dashed, right-click onto it and pick Set Dashed from the context menu. Vice versa, select Set Solid to change a dashed bar into a solid one. If you would like to have different fill colors for your bars or other timeline items, left-click once on the item and choose your preferred color from the drop-down menu. Insert a new bar into your Gantt by right-clicking into a row and selecting New Bar from the context menu. Adjust the start and end date of the new bar as described earlier. Another way to quickly fill your Gantt chart with timeline items is to copy existing bars to other rows. just select the bar you want to copy, or multi-select by shift-clicking more bars, then hold down Ctrl and drag the selection to another row. Release and adjust the start and end dates as needed. Let's say you'd like to display date labels for some of the activity bars. Just right-click on the bar and pick Add Date Label from the context menu. You can edit the format of the date by left-clicking on the label and either picking one of the entries in the drop-down menu or typing your desired number format directly into the control box. Feel free to add other text to the date label if needed. Now that we are done with the activity bars, let's add milestones to your Gantt. Milestones mark singular events in your timeline chart. Hover your mouse over a row at the position you want to place the milestone. Red crosshairs and the tooltip will help you find the exact date. Right-click and select New Milestone from the context menu. The milestone is inserted at the crosshair position. You can, of course, change the date of the milestone afterwards if needed, either by double-clicking on it and picking the new date from the calendar, or by dragging it. If you want to change the shape of the milestone, you left-click on it and select your preferred symbol from the drop-down menu, for example, diamond. Now let's add some more milestones to your chart. What do you do if the beginning of one of the activities depends on the completion of another? For these cases, ThinkCell gives you the option to anchor bars and other timeline items to each other. Let's learn how. Click and drag the handle of the item you want to anchor, and place it onto one of the anchor points that appear on other items. Release once you are happy with the anchor position. An anchor icon indicates that two items are connected. This means, for instance, that if you change the end date of a bar, the start date of another bar that is anchored to that point will change accordingly. To remove an anchor, just drag the handle away from the anchor point and release. Now that the timeline is filled, let's move on to setting row separators. Let's say you would like to separate the first and the last row from the rest. Right-click into the second row and select Add Row Separator. A separator is inserted above the second row. Repeat this for the bottom row. To remove unwanted separators in the middle, right-click on each and choose the red Delete button. For defining responsibilities, status, and remarks with regard to an activity, ThinkCell's Gantt chart offers you two extra columns. You add them by right-clicking into your Activity column and selecting Add Responsible Label Column or Add Remark Label Column. If you pick Add Responsible Label Column, for instance, a new column is inserted to the right of the chart labeled Responsible. Here you can enter the names of the people and teams who work on that particular task. Just hover over the row and click on the empty label you would like to fill. The label frame turns blue and you can start typing. Right-click into the new column and select Add Remark Label Column to add another column to the right where you can leave remarks. As with any labels in ThinkCell, you are of course free to change the heading label of the columns. In addition to text labels, you can also add ideograms to your remark or responsible column. Just hover over the label until you see the orange frame. Right-click on it and select either Switch to Harvey Ball or Switch to Checkbox. You can format the appearance of a Harvey ball by left-clicking on it once. ThinkCell's toolbar opens and lets you change the completion state, the number of Harvey ball fractions, as well as the usual format settings like size, color, and outline. For inserted checkboxes, you can, for instance, edit the symbol and symbol color from the left-click toolbar. A quick way to change the completion state of the Harvey ball or the symbol of the checkbox is to double-click the ideogram. When you fill your remark and responsible column, you may want to apply a text label or an ideogram to more than one activity row. For instance, because a team or person is responsible for more than one activity represented in your Gantt. In this case, you can make the label span two or more rows. Select the label by clicking on its frame. One drag handle appears above and one below. Click on one of the handles and drag it to the desired row position. A bracket is inserted to show that the label entry refers to a group of rows. Repeat this for other text labels, Harvey balls, or checkboxes if needed. Now you are done. You have built a professional-looking Gantt chart with your project timeline in only a few minutes. If you would like to go further, ThinkCell also offers a variety of other timeline items you can add to your Gantt, like process arrows, shades, brackets, or milestone lines. Inserting, deleting, and editing them works just as with the items explained in this video. So feel free to try all the other features and formatting options ThinkCell offers. If you're interested in using data from an Excel file to control your timeline items, please watch our tutorial entitled Excel-based Gantt chart. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.